Welcome. We're welcoming Professor Dawn Eden Goldstein to our show today on Skype. Professor Goldstein teaches at Holy Apostles and writes under the pen name Dawn Eden. And she's author of the book, My Peace I Give You, Healing Sexual Wounds with the Help of the Saints. She also wrote, Remembering God's Mercy, Redeem the Past and Free Yourself from Painful Memories. Welcome to the show, Professor.
Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be on.
Well, in looking at your book, I was really impressed by the fact that the communion of saints is really a means by which people can be healed, especially from sexual violations. And that's what you were talking about, like sexual wounds from people who were victims of child sexual abuse. And one in particular was Blessed Laura Vicuña. Can you talk a little bit about her and your connection with that particular saint?
Certainly. It was very meaningful for me to discover Blessed Laura because, as I write in My Peace I Give You, I grew up in an abusive home environment. After my parents' divorce, there was a man in the house, one of my mother's boyfriends, who was abusive. And when I discovered Blessed Laura's story, I was stunned to discover that here is a blessed of the Catholic Church who lived in the same kind of environment that I lived in, who was abused by her mother's live-in lover. But as I'm sure you know from your own inspirational writings, Danielle, you know, it's one thing to learn that a saint suffered the same as us. That's a good thing. But what we really want to learn is, how did that saint find healing? Mm-hmm. And so in reading about Blessed Laura's great courage, and in this wonderful sense of self and union with Jesus that she had, that could only come from the Holy Spirit, I was given some real tools to help with my own healing. And that's what I sought to share in writing My Peace I Give You.
Right. And I mean, that's what I was really moved by, that I think this book must have been very cathartic for you, being a victim yourself. But then other victims too, there's so much hope inside of this book in connecting with these saints and in finding that kind of healing that can only come from sometimes very uncomfortably laying bare these wounds. How have you found healing through your writing process?
I definitely recommend that anyone seeking healing consider keeping a journal, writing about it. And they've actually found, research has found, and people who are not only religious but secular agree on this, that keeping a gratitude journal is very important. In a sense, my books are like a gratitude journal. I feel this right now because I'm currently writing my conversion memoir for Catholic Answers, and I'm always thinking of the reader in terms of that I don't want to leave the reader in his or her pain. Mm-hmm. I want to bring the reader to a sense of joy and peace and gratitude. So I look in my past for you know, even in the painful times, where was God trying to lead me to a closer relationship with Him? And I think that that's what writing can do.
Right. And also, you share so beautifully about the ways in which your faith kind of helped you along that path to healing. And some people who are victims might shy away from the Catholic religion and feel like they don't have a place there. Can you share a little bit about how your faith helped you to heal?
Well, that's a great question, Danielle. I was recently asked by a Catholic professor, how do I keep my own faith in the midst of continued news of past abuse committed by people in the church. For me, I experienced my abuse outside of the church, so I don't have the same experience as someone who's abused by someone in the church. But having had that experience, I knew when coming into the church that baptism, it removes original sin, but it doesn't remove the possibility that we might sin, that there are certainly sinners in the church as well as outside. The question is, if the church acted according to her own beliefs, we speak of the church as a she, then would it be an ideal world? And the Catholic Church is the only institution that I've found in the whole world where, if everyone acted according to the beliefs of this institution, we would have paradise, we would have heaven. So that's why I stay. You know, as St. Peter said, you know, to whom shall we go, Lord? You know, Jesus has the keys to eternal life, and he's given them to his church.
Very true, very true. Beautifully said, and a great reminder to all of us to not take for granted that gift that we have inside of the church. Well, Professor, before we have to go, can you let us know where people can go to find out more about you and your work and possibly get a copy of this important book?
Thank you. Well, they can certainly go to dawneden.blogspot.com or to my Twitter account at Dawn of Mercy. And all my books are available wherever fine books are sold.
Wonderful. Well, we'll be sure to check that out. Thank you so much for taking the time to share about this. And thank you for your important ministry. God bless you.